guys, it's Abby Grace, and today's video is going to be 9 life hacks for gymnasts. This video was requested by Hannah Wright, so thank you so much for requesting the video.
Hi guys, this is Editing Abby. Sorry this video is a day late. I was very busy with school, and this video took forever to edit. Hope you still enjoy
it. Going into the video, don't worry about this poop on top of my head. My hair looks like trash today. That's okay. Also, this video is like so 2015's kind of thing, like when everybody did life hacks. So that's why there's like the montage in the beginning, because I want to be like, life hacks. So anyways, let's get started. The reason why I only have 9 and I don't have 10, because I spent all morning looking for life hacks and I could only find 9. So yeah. So the first hack is probably the easiest one. I used this hack when I was getting my back hand. Basically, you put a scrunchie around your feet and it helps you keep your legs together in your back handspring, because a lot of times in it, your legs come apart. So this is a really helpful hack for anybody who's just gotten their back handspring. I use this one a lot. My next hack is a DIY beam. So basically, you are going to get a mat, or you can even do this on the floor if you are allowed to, and you're just going to take tape, and you can make it as long as you want, but just have it 4 inches wide so then it's the same as the beam. And basically, you can just practice skills on it. Like, basically, like, if you don't have a beam, it's great for it. The next hack is a hair tie holder. This, you can get, like, any, like, hook, like what I have, or, like, a ring. And you can just put all your hair ties, all your scrunchies, any of that on there. And you can put it in your bathroom. You can put it on your gym bag. I always kept mine on my gym bag. And this is just a great hack because you're always going to need hair ties just in case one breaks. And everybody at the gym always needs hair ties. This next one is to improve your flexibility. Basically, what you are going to do is you're just going to sit in your splits, whatever skill you need to get more flexible in. And you can just watch TV like this. You can just watch videos, go on your phone, you know, like just sit around and just do stuff while you're in that skill. Really just sit around and focus your mind on what's going on and not what your body is doing. It's really helpful, and if you do this every day, you will improve your flexibility. Next hack sounds kind of weird, but it worked for me to get my pullover. Basically, what you want to do is you want to bite your Leo, or if you're wearing a shirt, you want to bite your shirt, and it'll help you keep your head in. I always throw my head out, so this is very helpful for me. Next hack is to help get your kip. So basically, you're going to get like a broom or any stick you can find, and you're just going to lay down, hold this stick up, like your arms up and hold it, and you are going to put your feet to the stick, and then you're just going to come up, as you can see in the video. This is a really good drill for learning your kip, and I definitely recommend it. I did it so many times before I got my kip. The next hack is to film yourself. Filming yourself will have the ability to, you can see what you messed up on, and I do this all the time. I mean, I have a YouTube channel, so I have to film myself, and it's really helped me see like where I'm bending my legs or something. The next one is to break in your grips. Whenever you get grips, you have to break them in. They're kind of really stiff and you need to get them to fit to your hand and stuff. So the first thing you can do is kind of roll them up and like keep them like that overnight, and they will help them mold to the bar better because they have to have a natural curve, and when you get them, they're very straight. Another thing you can do is kind of just swing on the bar. That's what my coach had us do. She always had us just do 100 tap swings on the bar to help warm up our grips and also to get used to them, because a lot of times doing skills with your grips are a little scary. The last and final life hack is to set goals. My gym had us bring notebooks, and we had to write down like goals and different things that we wanted to do at the next meet and how we think we did at practice and stuff. And this is really helpful. We'd also use this to, like, if we were having a mental block, our coach would have us like write down, I can do this skill, like over and over until, like, I don't know, she told us like amount of times we had to do it. So I hope you guys like this video. I'm sorry I'm not the best at life hacks or like these kind of videos. I never was, I never will be. Thank you guys so much for watching. Also, we are so close to 800 subscribers. Yeah, definitely make sure you subscribe. I'm really trying to reach 1,000 subscribers. All my social medias will be linked down below in the description. I hope you guys like this video. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. Bye!